Today we want to derive Lorentz transformation. It will be a special case of this transformation for a situation. We have two inertial frames of reference, the first and the second. And we assume that the second frame of reference is moving with a constant speed v in the direction of the axis x. The more general Lorentz transformation is for the case where when this velocity has components in all in the direction of all axes. I should remind you about Galileo transformation. We know that this transformation is not true because it does not comply with the main postulates of special theory of relativity. I mean that velocity, the speed of light, is the same in all inertial frames of reference, and that nothing can move faster than light. Lorentz transformation comply with these main postulates of special theory of relativity. So let's do it. Galileo transformation is not true, but it let us foresee the form of the real transformation. Helps us to foresee the form of the real transformation. We see that a special coordinate x dash depends on x and t linearly. We expect that the same will be in the real Lorentz transformation. And we know that Lorentz transformation for velocities much slower than the speed of light should give up as Galileo transformation. So we foresee the form of the real transformation. We see that x dash depends on x and t linearly. A and B are just constants, and we should calculate these constants. It will be easy to calculate the constant B. Let's assume that for the t equal to zero, both beginnings of these two frames will be in the same place. So this point will be in will be here. And let's assume that some event happens in the beginning of the second frame of reference. So x dash of this event is equal to zero. X is equal v times t because this point is moving in the direction of the axis x with the speed v. Now we'll just put these values to the equations above and it's lab here, and we can calculate from this equation the constant p. Then we just put this value here, and we could write it in this form. If you want to find inverse transformation, then we just put in the place, change x dash to x to x dash, t to t dash, and v to minus v. We should understand that v in this equation is not the value of velocity. It is a coordinate of velocity vector. I should remind that if a vector is parallel to the axis, then the coordinate of the vector is equal to value of this vector if this vector is directed the same as the axis, but is equal to minus value of vector if the vector is opposite to the axis. Now we want to calculate the constant A. How to do it? Let's assume once more that for the t equal to zero, beginnings of all of these two frames of reference are in the same place, and we send a beam of light from this point and also from this point in the direction of the axis x and of course x dash. Then we could write that x is equal to c times t and x dash is equal to c times t dash. It is because velocity, speed of light in all inertial frames of reference is the same, is equal to c. Then it's enough to put these values x and x and x dash to these two equations. So here we just put c times t dash. Here we put c times t. Here we put c times t, and here we put c times t dash. We can change the form of these equations to such, and we change the size of the second equation. It's down here, and we divide left sides of these two equations and then right sides of these equations. We achieve such equation. Now we can transform this equation and calculate the value of constant A. And it's done here. Now we put this constant to both these equations, and we have and then we would have transformations of coordinate x and x dash, and it is on the second tape. So now we'll put the value of constant A to both of these equations, like I have it here, and that's a Lorentz transformation for coordinate x and inverse transformation. Now we only have to find the transformation of time. We'll use these two equations, and from this inverse transformation, we'll calculate x dash, and it's done here. And we put this value, right side of this equation, to this place. And it's done here. Now we change the sign of this expression and multiply both sides of this equation by the square root of 1 minus v squared by c squared. If we multiply this root by this root, just the root will vanish, and we'll achieve 1 minus this v squared by c squared multiplied by x. And we have it here. If we multiply this by this root will vanish. And if we multiply this expression by this root, we will have such expression. Now we see that we can get rid of x, and if we divide all both sides of this equation by v, we achieve such equation. Now it's enough to transform this equation and calculate t dash float. But it's done now. Here we calculated t dash from the previous equation, and to find inverse transformation, we just change in this equation t dash to t to t dash, x to x dash, and v to minus v. We should understand what is v in this equation. It is not value of velocity. It is coordinate of velocity vector, and it is expressed by such equation. Delta x can be greater than zero if the second frame of reference is moving in the same direction as the axis x, and delta x is less than zero if the second frame of reference is moving opposite to the axis x. And we know that the first frame of reference is moving in this direction related to the second frame of reference. So the coordinate of velocity v is less than zero. Here instead of v we put minus v, and we have inverse transformation. Now we can write all this transformation in one place. We should remember that there is no movement in the direction of axis y and z, so these coordinates don't change. And the problem we try to solve, we've solved. So it's the end of this lesson.